Hello guys, welcome back. I am going to talk about my watch a little bit because you guys have asked to hear more about how I feel after a week of using it. And so I want to show you some of the things I've gotten used to, how much I enjoy it, and talk about pros and cons, basically. I bought the watch. I got the watch on April 30th, and it is May the 9th right now. So I've had the watch, you know, for 9-10 days at this point. I don't know if it was the 31st day in April. I can't remember. So 9-10 days at this point, and I've wore it, you know, pretty much every day. Common questions are battery life. You know, how's the battery life, Guude? Battery life is good. I say you could wear the watch for about 48 hours before it's going to need a charge. I tend to take everything off at night, glasses, watch, everything off when I go to bed. So I have not worn it through the night, but I have gone close to 48 hours without charging it. So, what else? Things that I find most useful. I really enjoy the activity portion of the watch. Every time since it's not on my wrist, I have to put in the passcode each time I unlock it, but I figured it'd be easier to show it to the GoPro here if it wasn't on my wrist. So I really enjoy the activity portion of the watch. Today I've walked apparently 1.73 miles, taken 3,888 steps. That part, you know, that's great, whatever. The thing is, like, you know, your phone can technically do that, but generally you're not going to be carrying your phone around with you. And me particularly, I leave my phone out in my car, because I don't get a cell phone reception in the house generally. What I've been doing is having my Mac open so that the text would come through, but now that I have the watch, I can get the text on my phone, and it, you know, forwards to the watch, so I can still leave my phone outside in my car where I do get cell phone reception, and just use the watch instead of having to have my whole Mac so that I can see when I get text. I think it probably locked on me here. No, it didn't. So there's that. Day-to-day use, where am I finding I use it the most? Obviously, to tell the time, there's no question there. And then the parts that remind you to stand up once an hour, so that have been convenient, you know. I mean, I don't necessarily need that in my life, you know, to stand and get to move around, but it is convenient. I use this part for recording a lot. I'll set, you know, a timer, a reminder here, 20 some minutes or so, and that way if we're going, I've been setting it to 23 to be exact, and that way if we've gone way over or what, you know, about 23, I get a reminder of how long we've been recording, and that way once we find a good spot to stop, we do. What else have I been finding really useful? Obviously the friend function is nice for, you know, quickly sending a text back and forth to my wife or whatever while I'm in the car, and I just can use the voice to text, so that's convenient. Obviously getting my tweets from people that I follow and stuff like that, it's really nice to have it just, you know, right there on your wrist. That's so one of my favorite things about my watch is my home security system. If you look at the face of my watch right now, you'll see that, I put the watch back on just because it was easier to show this. You'll see the front outside of my house. All my security cameras, basically my entire house, I have a security camera in every room of my house. I have security cameras outside of my house on all the different angles of my house, and I actually didn't know I could set it all up for motion tracking, but Co and I were talking about it the other day, and he found a manual that shows how to easily do that. Not only that, you know, not only do I have the cameras and everything, but every light in my house is set up. So, for instance, here's the bathroom light. I could turn the bathroom light off with my watch. I could always do it with my phone, but like I said, I have to leave my phone out in my car so that I get cell phone service and stuff like that, and I, you know, couldn't do that. So generally we just use the lights in the house like a normal light. We just, you know, on or off. But with this, you know, I can do it from my phone, which that's all well and good. I don't really use that a lot. We just use the lights like a normal light in the house. But with the security stuff, I also have every door and window in my house set up where I would normally get a push notification on my phone and a text and an email if anything opens up out of the ordinary. Now I get it on my wrist, which is even more convenient. And I can easily just go tap, let me see what the camera sees. Right here from my wrist, you know, cut all the lights in my house. The same thing with, like, the water heater bust. I have a sensor down there that's all tied in with the same system. So if there's a leak in any of the sinks, you know, underneath the sinks or the water heater, any of those, same thing. Get a notification right here. So any door, any window in my house opens, bam, right there on the watch. Easily can look and see what the camera sees. Same thing with all my smoke detectors. I use First Alert smoke detectors and carbon monoxide detectors in my house. And if there's ever any type of thing like that, right there on my wrist. Generally, it would have been on the phone. Even better on the wrist. Like I said, I often leave my phone outside and miss it, or even whenever we're going to conventions and things like that, I'll often not feel my phone in my pocket. On my wrist, though, won't miss it. So those things are very convenient and really handy for me. Being someone that travels a lot, I like to be able to check in on my house, you know, and things like, you know, it's just fantastic, right? The built-in Uber app is great, you know, but I could do that on my phone, so I don't really need the watch for that. One of the things that I found convenient when we traveled to the beach this last week was when driving, I looked up the directions on my phone, it automatically transfers over to the watch, and I easily have the watch telling me when it's time to turn. And it's not only telling me when it's time to turn, it's tapping me on the wrist to let me know that my turn's coming up. So, you know, if you have your music going or whatever and you don't hear your GPS, then you have it right on your wrist. So, these are all things you don't necessarily need in your life, but they sure are convenient when you have them. I guess the last thing that that you know really has stood out to me as something that I really enjoy is just the heart rate monitor itself. The fact that I can go to my phone here and look at what my heart rate has been doing over periods of time is really convenient to me. You know, you can look at the last week and you can easily see what my heart was doing any period of the day. And what I found convenient about that is that I've learned a lot about myself. You know, I've always known that I didn't really enjoy driving. I went for a period of like 8 years where I just didn't drive. I even let my license expire. And there was no reason for that. I just didn't like to drive, and so I stopped. I used to feel really anxious when I drove or rode in a car, but I haven't really noticed in a long time, so I thought I'd gotten over that. But one thing I've learned from my health monitor is that I have not gotten over that. My heart goes insane when I'm in a car. I don't even notice it. So that's very interesting to me. Let's see here. Is there anything else that has really stood out has been amazing? I mean, you know, obviously just this nonstop monitoring I really enjoy and like. Are there anything I don't like about the watch? And the answer to that is the weight. I find it to be a little bit heavy. I'm still getting used to the weight itself. But other than that, I think that's my only complaint so far is that whenever, like when I stand up and it's on my side, you can feel the heaviness of it. But other than that, no. Could I do everything that I just described to you guys with another watch? No, that's not really possible. And I know a lot of people critique the price of the watch, but for three, I look at like Beef and his watches that he has, his collection of watches, and I ask them what they cost and stuff, and like $5,000, $6,000, $7,000, $8,000 or whatever, not 8,000, you know, 1,000, $5,000, $6,000, $7,000, $800 up to $1,000, and versus a $300 watch. I mean, this one was, you know, I didn't get the sport, so, but they start at $300. But I don't need to justify that price, I guess, to anyone. If you find it useful in your life and you think it would be cool, then sure, get it. I think that, I know when I was younger, you see things as status symbols, and you get over that once you become an adult. Not everyone does, but most adults get over that type of stuff. You know, like I remember in school, you had to have the new Nikes, the new Jordans, or whatever. No. If you're buying this watch because you want some kind of status symbol or something like that, just save your money. Has anyone noticed this watch on me at all in public? Not a single person. Would I want them to? Absolutely not. I don't want strangers coming up and talking to me about things that I own or just because. Don't come talk to me just because I have a watch on, please. That would be awkward. So those are the things. If someone's younger, I can understand that's how they see it, and that's just it's just not it's naivety. Naivety? Is that the right word? Whatever. You know what I mean. So that's about it. That's how I feel about the watch. I really enjoyed it. It has been useful in my life, at least. And I'm very happy with my purchase and would purchase again. As far as my Apple fanboyism, I do have pretty much almost every Apple product that exists. And I've never, ever had one break, and that's fantastic. Like, my wife still uses my old iPhone 4. But that also said, I did recently throw my Samsung Note 3 into a pool, thinking it was waterproof, and it's not. but I let it dry out for a week and put the battery back in, and it started again, too. So I haven't had any problems with my Samsung stuff either, even after throwing it in a pool. I've never tried throwing my iPhone in a pool. I'm not going to try that. And I have not tested any water resistance with this, and I don't intend to do that either. Obviously, it's been rained on and things like that. But, yeah. I think that's about it, for me at least, as regards to this. I think I've covered everything that I found useful. It's got lots of other functionality. Like, you can use your camera with it, and it pairs with the phone. And now my camera's, it's going to show you the GoPro over here, GoProception. I don't know a lot of functionality for that. I mean, I guess you could set up your phone across the room and take a picture from far away. I haven't found a use for that yet. It has a Delta app on here that I'm interested in seeing how it works. In flight, it claims that it'll tell me everything about my baggage long before I land, and I already have that in this app, so I don't know if I'll find that useful. For me, the most of the stuff that's been useful is the type of health monitoring things that it does, and for myself, just the built-in, the fact that my home security system already works so flawlessly with it and seamlessly has been really great, because I definitely have used that quite a bit. So for me, that's how I feel about the watch. I've really enjoyed it, and that's the face I chose, by the way. I do want them to make this customizable, and I'm sure the Android watches are customizable on the face here. I would probably put the G logo in this rectangle here if it was customizable, and I imagine that is something that will come with time. But one thing I do like is the weather stuff is pretty cool here. Once it loads, you get like an hourly here on the stuff. So you get like obviously you can pull the stuff up online, but it's just convenient, you know. Having Siri here on your wrist too is pretty convenient. So there's like a 50% chance of rain here in the morning, looks like. Like yesterday, I was on the other end of the house, and so my phone was outside, obviously. And we were like, Just Vaughn was tweeting, and it was like 11 o'clock at night, and my wife was like, time is it there? And so I was like, I don't know. And she's like, ask Siri. And I was like, oh yeah, I guess so. And so I asked Siri what time it was in Japan, and she told me. Great, you know. you could obviously do that with a phone or a computer. I didn't have one. No, I have a phone computer on my wrist all the time. So that's about it. I like it. And it's whether or not you like something like that or need something like that in your life. That's all there is to it. I think a lot of people see these type of things, like I said, like status symbols or stupid shit like that, and that's just stupid. Don't live your life like that. Or do, and be miserable. Who gives a fuck? I certainly don't. If you enjoy being miserable, by all means, whatever makes you happy. And if being miserable makes you happy, it's fucked up, but I guess that's you. So anyways, I hope you guys have enjoyed. Have a good day, and I'll see you later. Bye.